Ever wondered why things happen to you? Discover Carl Jung's profound insights on learning from your own guilt to transform your life. We've all felt it, that pang of guilt. It can feel heavy, like a weight on our shoulders. But what if I told you that guilt, when understood, can be a powerful tool for growth? Our feelings of guilt often hold important messages. These messages can help us understand ourselves better. They can guide us to make better choices. By facing our guilt, we can live more authentically. Think of guilt as a messenger. It's not there to punish us. It points us toward areas where we might be out of alignment with our values. Maybe we haven't been treating ourselves or others with kindness. Maybe we've made mistakes that we need to address. By listening to our guilt, we can begin to heal and grow. Imagine trying to hold a beach ball underwater. The harder you push it down, the more forcefully it pops back up. By facing our guilt with courage and compassion, we can understand its message and find freedom from its grip. Carl Jung was a wise man who studied the human mind. He believed that our feelings of guilt hold valuable lessons. He said, "One does not become enlightened by imagining figures of light, but by making the darkness conscious." Jung believed that true growth comes from facing our shadows. Our shadows are the parts of ourselves that we hide. Our fears, our insecurities, our mistakes. By bringing them into the light of awareness, we can begin to heal them. Jung's words remind us that personal growth is not always easy. It requires honesty and courage. By facing our darkness, we open ourselves to a deeper understanding of who we are and what we're capable of becoming. By acknowledging our guilt and understanding its roots, we allow ourselves to grow and become stronger. Jung's wisdom offers a roadmap for this journey, guiding us toward wholeness and self-acceptance. Relationships are at the heart of our lives. They bring us joy, love, and support. But they can also be a source of conflict and pain. Guilt often surfaces in our relationships, highlighting areas where we need to grow. It might be something we said that hurt a loved one, a promise we broke, or a time we weren't there for someone in need. Imagine this. You promised your partner you'd cook dinner, but you got caught up at work and ordered takeout instead. You feel a pang of guilt because you didn't keep your word. Now you could easily brush it off or make excuses, but what if you saw this guilt as an opportunity to grow? By acknowledging your guilt, you can start a conversation with your partner. Apologize for not keeping your promise. Explain what happened and explore how you can better manage your time in the future. By doing so, we create stronger, more fulfilling connections. Our careers take up a big part of our lives. They can be a source of fulfillment and purpose, but they can also bring about stress, self-doubt, and yes, even guilt. Maybe we didn't speak up when we had a good idea. Maybe we made a mistake that cost the team time or money. Or perhaps we feel guilty for not pursuing our passions. Imagine you're passed over for a promotion at work. You feel a wave of disappointment, but also a pang of guilt. You start to question your abilities. Instead, try looking at the situation through the lens of guilt as a teacher. What can you learn from this experience? Perhaps you need to develop new skills or communicate your achievements more effectively. By facing your guilt and exploring its message, you can transform a challenging experience into an opportunity for growth. Remember, setbacks are a natural part of life. It's how we learn and grow from them that truly matters. Perhaps the most important relationship we have is with ourselves. How we treat ourselves, the words we use in our heads, and the expectations we set all contribute to our sense of self-worth. Guilt often arises when we feel we've fallen short of our own expectations. We judge ourselves harshly for our mistakes, our perceived flaws, and our moments of weakness. Think about a time you made a mistake that you now regret. Maybe you said something hurtful in the heat of the moment. Or perhaps you made a decision that didn't align with your values. But what if, instead of beating ourselves up, we treated ourselves with the same compassion and understanding that we would offer a good friend? This is the path to self-acceptance. Remember, we are all works in progress. By embracing our imperfections and treating ourselves with kindness, we cultivate a stronger sense of self-love and acceptance. Now you might be wondering, how do I actually start listening to my guilt? One powerful tool is meditation. At its core, meditation is about creating space for stillness and self-reflection. Find a quiet spot where you can sit comfortably. Close your eyes and turn your attention to your breath. Notice the rise and fall of your chest as you inhale and exhale. As thoughts come up, simply acknowledge them without judgment and gently guide your attention back to your breath. As you practice meditation, you'll start to notice that you become more aware of your thoughts and feelings, including those pangs of guilt. Instead of pushing them away, you can observe them with curiosity and compassion. Ask yourself, what is this guilt trying to tell me? What can I learn from this experience? Another powerful tool for self-reflection is journaling. Think of your journal as a safe and private space to explore your thoughts and feelings without judgment. It's a place to be completely honest with yourself, to process your experiences, and to gain clarity about your emotions. When you feel a pang of guilt, take out your journal and start writing. Don't censor yourself or worry about grammar or punctuation. Just let your thoughts flow freely onto the page. Write about the situation that triggered the guilt. Explore why you feel guilty. What are the underlying values or beliefs that are being challenged? As you write, you might be surprised by what emerges. Journaling can help us uncover hidden patterns in our behavior, can help us cultivate self-compassion by offering a space to process difficult emotions and offer ourselves kindness. As you begin to explore your guilt and work towards personal growth, it's important to remember that perfection is an illusion. None of us are perfect. We all make mistakes. We all have regrets. And that's okay. In fact, our imperfections are what make us unique and interesting. They are the source of our creativity, our resilience, and our capacity for growth. When we embrace our imperfections, we give ourselves permission to be human. We allow ourselves to learn and grow from our experiences without the weight of unrealistic expectations. Think of a time you tried something new and made a mistake. Maybe you were learning to play a new instrument, trying a new recipe, or starting a new hobby. Often, our greatest growth comes from our mistakes. They teach us valuable lessons and help us develop new skills. Understanding our guilt and embracing our imperfections is an important step, but it's only the beginning. True growth requires action. It requires us to have the courage to make changes in our lives. Changes that align with our values, our goals, and our authentic selves. This might mean having difficult conversations with loved ones, setting boundaries in our relationships, or making a career change that feels risky but ultimately fulfilling. It might mean facing our fears and stepping outside of our comfort zones. Change can be scary, but it's also incredibly liberating. When we summon the courage to make changes that align with our true selves, we open ourselves up to a world of possibilities. We create space for growth, joy, and fulfillment. Start with small steps. Identify one area of your life where you'd like to make a change, and then take action. Celebrate your progress along the way, and don't be afraid to ask for support when you need it. The journey of self-discovery is a lifelong adventure. It's not a destination, but rather a process of continuous growth, learning, and evolution. As we delve deeper into ourselves, we gain a greater understanding of our motivations, our desires, and our place in the world. We develop a stronger sense of self-awareness and compassion. This self-understanding brings with it a profound sense of freedom. We are no longer held captive by our past mistakes or our limiting beliefs. We are free to make choices that align with our values, to pursue our passions, and to live a life that is authentic and meaningful to us. Life will inevitably throw us curveballs. But with self-understanding comes the resilience to navigate these challenges with grace and wisdom. The journey of self-discovery is a gift you give yourself. It's a journey of healing, growth, and transformation. You've heard the call to adventure. You've glimpsed the transformative power that lies within understanding your own guilt. Now it's time to take the first step on your own journey of self-discovery. Embrace the wisdom of Carl Jung and remember that one does not become enlightened by imagining figures of light, but by making the darkness conscious. Start by creating space for reflection. Engage in practices like meditation and journaling, allowing yourself to explore your inner landscape with curiosity and compassion. Listen to the whispers of your guilt, not as a voice of condemnation, but as a guide pointing you towards growth. Embrace your imperfections. Remember that you are a work in progress, perfectly imperfect in your own unique way. Celebrate your strengths, acknowledge your weaknesses, and extend the same kindness to yourself that you would offer to a dear friend. The journey of self-discovery is not always easy, but it is always worthwhile. Take a deep breath, trust your inner wisdom, and begin. Your journey starts now. Unlock the power of self-understanding with Carl Jung's wisdom. Begin your journey of personal growth by looking into your own heart and learning from your experiences. If this video resonated with you, please like, share, and subscribe for more transformative insights. Together, let's embrace the path to self-discovery and live our best lives.